you very much for meeting with us at YGTV today, Mr. Featon.
Well, thank you very much for inviting me.
In the opposition's opinion, how has the government signalled a U-turn policy for the future job strategy?
Well, you may recall that during the last general election, this was one of the cornerstones of the GSLP Liberals election campaign. And I think that it proved very popular amongst young people. Now, what they were saying at that stage was that they would implement this policy by the 1st of February, that people would be invited onto 3-year training courses, employed by a government company, and that they would have a full-time guaranteed job at the end of their training. Now, we know that actually the people that have the people that have been invited onto the scheme, that will start on the scheme on the 1st of February, are those who have been on existing training schemes, the VTS, the vocational training schemes, and also those on sheltered employment. In relation to the unemployed, or those on casual and supply work, those people will not be able to come onto the scheme on the 1st of February as trainees are able to do so, and they will have to wait until June and July. But what is worst about this is that it now transpires that actually there is no guaranteed full-time job at the end of their training scheme. It's impossible. Because you see, rather than the government through this privately owned company actually guaranteeing the jobs at the end of the training, what the government is now saying is that they will be guaranteed a job within a private company. Now that's impossible because you cannot predict what is going to happen to that private company within the year or 2 years or 3 years that it takes to train that individual. That company may well go out of business, that company's economic situation may turn, the economic situation in Gibraltar may turn for the worse, and therefore it's impossible to guarantee. So you have a situation where they made great play of the fact that there was a guaranteed full-time job at the end of their training. People were led to believe that this was going to be in the public sector, in a government-owned company, and that is simply not the case. And we believe that this is a monumental U-turn, and that indeed it has been a monumental con on the electorate, and particularly those who are in a vulnerable situation are unemployed, because they voted GSLP expecting training on the 1st of February and a full-time job guaranteed at the end of their training. That is simply not going to happen.
In a statement yesterday, the GSD noted that any person on the scheme who is not offered employment by the private sector will be sacked by the government company after their training is complete. All the scheme trainees have been told that if that is the case, they will be moved on to another placement until they are offered employment by the private company they're training for. Which is the correct information?
Well, we believe that we are correct. Look, the position, as it was argued during the general election, was you finish your training, you will be guaranteed a full-time job at the end of it. And the implication was that the full-time job would be within a government-owned company. We now know that that is not the case, and that effectively people will not even be allowed onto the scheme. People will not be allowed onto the scheme unless they've already got an offer of a full-time job offer by a private company within the private sector before you go on to the scheme. Or alternatively, it's the government itself that actually invites you onto the scheme because it's able to match your skill with skills available in a private company. Now, it's impossible to guarantee a job in that kind of situation. Now, even if you take the GSLP's position at its highest, they say, well, we'll just simply move you to another placement. What are they saying? Are they saying that effectively people are going to be in a perpetual state of training? It's absolutely ridiculous. What they should be doing is honouring their commitment as they expressed it in their manifesto and also at the last general election. People that finish their training courses should be offered full-time jobs because that is what they were. That is what the promise was at the last general election. And now what you see is a situation where they've managed to attract all these votes, and of course they're now backtracking because it's impossible. They found out that it's impossible to actually employ 1,000 individuals within effectively the public sector in a government-owned company. The reality of the situation is going to be that you cannot keep people in perpetuity being trained. And of course, if those people can't find a job within the private sector, what is the government going to do? The answers in Parliament indicated to us that effectively what is going to happen is that those people will just simply be effectively sacked, which raises other issues as to whether the government is then exposed to unfair dismissal claims by people. Because, of course, if you've got somebody that's employed 3 years within a government-owned company, albeit on a training course, but that the intention is that they have full employment rights, after a year, they acquire rights not to be dismissed without recourse to an industrial tribunal. And all this is going to do is it's just simply going to expose the government to claims in the industrial tribunal. Either that, or alternatively, they keep people in a perpetual state of training. Because, you know, you've only got three alternatives. Either they offer people, as they promise in their manifesto, a guaranteed full-time job at the end of their training, or alternatively, they keep people in perpetual training, because they can't find a full-time job in the private sector, or they get sacked, and they just allow them to leave. And if they allow them to leave in that kind of situation, the government is exposing themselves, in our view, to unfair dismissal claims.
Do you think that the wage rise for vocational trainees is a positive change to the scheme policy?
Of course, it's a positive. Of course, it's a positive change. It's a positive change because people are going to be earning more, and I'm not going to argue about that. Our concern with this wasn't the fact that you are increasing the amount that people are going to be paid. Our concern with this from the very beginning was that the government was guaranteeing a full-time job, or the GSP Liberals during the general election, a full-time job at the end of their training. And we thought it was impossible for them to do that. And we said so during the election campaign. Now we find that, of course, we were right, because they're doing a monumental U-turn on their policy. They're not offering a full-time guaranteed job at the end of it, but just simply saying, no, if you're unemployed, those on training schemes are going to be allowed onto the scheme now. But if you're unemployed, it's going to be done in June, but only if we, the government, invite you onto the scheme, because we've been able to match your skills with skills that are required by a private company, or alternatively, because you've found an employer that is willing to employ you and therefore guarantee you a job at the end of it. That is an absolute nonsense. It's a travesty of what their policy was during the general election.
Thank you very much for speaking to us.